Well, what is new is that in the past we have developed techniques to label proteins with fluorophores in live cells, and now what we have is a fluorophore that can be excited in the near infrared, and that is very important because exciting fluorophores in the near infrared has less phototoxicity and you can penetrate deeper into tissue and so see proteins even in more complex samples. So as I told you before, the dye is particularly well suited for applications in live cells. And what you're seeing here is a protein that binds to microtubuli and the microtubuli organizing center of a live cell stained with our dye. And so you can follow the dynamics of the protein and how the cell moves. In addition, this is not only working for this particular protein, but what you see here on this image is different proteins in different localizations of the cell stained with the dye, demonstrating the generality of the approach. Well, the challenges were, or in general, the innovation in these kind of projects comes from the chemistry, and the challenge was to find a chemical structure of a fluorophore that is biocompatible and can be used in live cells. With respect to future applications, one particular interesting application of this kind of dye is its use in what is called super resolution microscopy, where you have a higher spatial resolution than with traditional techniques, and this dye appears to be very well suited for that. In addition, since we have a near-infrared dye, what would be nice is to use it in vivo, that is, in live animals, because near-infrared light can penetrate deeper into the tissue, and so the dye should be also very well suited for these kind of applications.